Father, we use all the things that they did not know. Amen. All the things that they didn't know. That all satanic power would be defeated and spoiled by his death on the cross. He brought us salvation. Salvation delivers you, but it can't keep you. Therefore, he said, I have to go away to send a comforter to keep you. Hallelujah. Is that all right? That the guarantee of the restoration of man's dominion will be accomplished at that time. Because God, when he made Adam and Eve, he said, go forth in dominion. We have dominion right now. God really don't know how to use it. God gave us dominion. That the church must be built and the church age run its course before the kingdom could come. Saints, we are the church age right now. We are the ecclesia. We are the called out one. We're living that time right now. Another thing that the Jewish people didn't know is that the many prophecies of the dispersion of the regathering of Israel, the reign of the Antichrist, and the future tribulation period, amen, they all have to take place. Amen? You see, Satan is going to be bound up for 1,000 years. Then he's going to be loosed again. But the thing about it is, what are we going to do when that time comes? Those of us that are right are going to be caught up in the tribulation. We're going to be caught up in the rapture. We're going to be gone. The tribulation time, the period is going to come. Amen. We go on to tell you some other things in prophecy. Jesus. But the fact of the matter is that they threw down the palms. Thinking that Jesus is coming in to the city to put down this Roman occupation. To destroy our captives. They found out that Jesus came. Amen. He had to fulfill some things, so he laid down his life. That eternity might be fulfilled in us.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
He died, he rose again. Amen. Palm Sunday, amen, represents today, as we have these palms up here, it represents that we won't make that same mistake again. We're not looking for Jesus to come.
That's right.
To put down sin.
That's right.
Put down ungodliness and unruliness. The devil is still the prince of this world. He's the prince of the air of this world. This reminds us that even though he's the prince of the air, we still have victory in Jesus.
Right.
In the spiritual sense.
Yeah.
If we have him in our hearts, if we have him in our life, Satan don't have no dominion over you. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
All those that gave their heart to God, even though the Roman occupation was there, the Romans didn't have dominion over them concerning their spiritual life.
Yeah.
Amen. These palms represent that Jesus is the King of our life. And we ought to give him praise. Give him glory. Amen.
Amen.
Not the fact that we should lay the palms down, but we should lay our lives down there. We should lay our hearts and our souls at this altar. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, glory, hallelujah. For the King is come. The King is come. The King is come and he has need of you.
Amen.
Are you willing to lay your heart down for him today?
Amen.
Are you willing to give your heart, your mind, your body, and soul to him today?
Amen.
Hallelujah. He's not looking just for an outward appearance of throwing your palms down, because he said, you praise me with your lips, but your heart is far from me. God says, I want your heart.
Yes, yes.
If I just have your lips, I won't have your heart necessarily.
Yes.
But if I have your heart, I'll have your lips. I'll have your worship and praise. Who is willing to give their heart to God this day? He died for us. Amen. I want everyone to come to the altar.